Thank you, Jesus.
Webster Dictionary defined the word belief as having confidence in the truth, existence, reliable, or value of something, and to have religious faith. For Christians, this definition is not just words on pages, it is a way of life. Our belief in faith is built on our acceptance of what we cannot see, but it's something that we feel deep within our hearts. Hebrews 11:1 reads, faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is a belief that one day we will stand before our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Too many people want physical proof before they will believe in anything. And I know that for myself, you know, I had to try God myself. So what I did is I went to Matthew 6:6, when I enter into the closet, pray unto the Father, which is in secret, and he reward my opening. So I actually did go into the closet and I did pray unto him. And he did touch me. And so that's why I'm here today, believing that I know that God can do all things.
Amen.
And he has changed me. You know, I was an alcoholic, drug addict, and today I'm a new person. One of Jesus' disciples said he would not believe, was raised from the dead, unless he saw Jesus for himself. And what did Jesus say to him when Thomas did this? When Thomas see the resurrection of Christ? John 20:29 reads, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe. And so up to this day, I believe. And I'm pretty sure you guys believe as well.
Amen.
You know, if you don't, you might as well start admitting right now, or getting on your knees and asking God to accept you right now, because otherwise it's going to be too late for you. Okay?
Amen.
So faith is a belief that what is said in the Bible is true, and the peace that we as Christians have when we turn our lives over to Jesus Christ. See, it's saying there again, you know, we have to turn our lives over to Jesus Christ in order to be saved, really. You know, if you still want to continue to live in the sin that you're living in, then hey, you got a choice. You either die, or either you want to live. As Christians, we do not only have a secure belief in God, we also accept the fact that what God tells us to do is for our best. That means you have no other choice but to believe him.
Amen.
A part of the definition of faith is accepting God, God's will over our lives, over our own will. This means that we understand that what God is asking us to do will always work out for the good for those who love and listen to him. One thing, you do have to listen to him. Otherwise, hey, you might just keep on going. Keep on stepping. Go ahead and go out there and listen to the devil. Romans 8:23 reads, all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose.
Yeah.
Someone once compared belief and faith to the wind. We cannot see the wind, we cannot hear the wind, unless it blows against something. We can only feel the wind when it touches our skin or blows through our hair. Belief is like the wind. We cannot see what we believe in, we cannot hear what we believe unless we open our hearts to the truth. And like I was saying, Matthew 6:6. But we can feel that our belief is real by the joy and peace we feel in our souls. Remember, in the end, we all must believe in something. Let your belief be in the word of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son who died for our sins and our justification. Just remember, you have to believe in God for yourself.
That's right.
You came into this world by yourself, you're leaving by yourself. Everybody, so go ahead and start accepting God in your life now and just get it over with. You cannot run, you cannot hide. So I give God the praise and the glory right now in the name of Jesus. Dear Heavenly Father, I come tonight, Father God, thank you right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father God, ask the Lord to touch someone tonight, Father God. And if they're not, if they need to turn their lives over now, Father God, I ask the Lord to touch them right now in the name of Jesus. Father God.